Hey everyone, this is Raja, Enterprise Agile Coach from ProXL Consulting. Now, reason number 5, iterative and incremental development is better than sequential waterfall development. What are the assumptions? Software development shall be done in a sequential, step-by-step manner. That's the assumption. It is possible. Like how an automobile is manufactured. You first make the chassis, move it to the next person, then the engine is fitted on that. So a sequential way of producing a Toyota Camry. So we believe software can also be developed sequentially, step by step. And we also assume customer can wait until the end of the projects to get the final deliverable. Why do we have to show them in between? No need. So that is another assumption. So what we do? Develop the software sequentially with one big final delivery in the end. If the customer is lucky or if the customer is insistent, probably you may make one or two additional deliveries. But otherwise, usually we deliver by the end of that life cycle. And what is the reality on this part? When the customers actually get to see the final deliverable, it may be very different from what they originally thought they would get. That happens almost always. And it is too late to change anything. When the customer sees the end product, this is almost the 11th month or 12th month when they were supposed to use this product. And when they come up with and find out this is not what they really wanted, they are in a fix. It is really very late to make any changes. That is why we have maintenance phase. So whatever changes you want right now, let's sign another contract and give me more money. Then I'll fix it over a period of time. Probably after 6 months or 8 months, you may get what you actually wanted. That's what we indirectly tend to say. And the result? Most of the customers are unhappy with the deliverables. Unfortunately, they are stuck with you. Probably they have to sign on with you for the maintenance project. So that is reason number 5. Let's look at a different context of the traditional development lifecycle. Analysis, design, coding, testing, as we already discussed, the time passes this way. The cost of change increases as the time passes. If the customer asks a change sometime in February, the second month of the development, probably it will be much cheaper to make the changes. If the customer wants a change somewhere during coding phase, it will be really very expensive because the requirements have been already understood and frozen and all the design have been done. If you request any changes here, I have to go back and change the design, change the requirements, and it is going to be cumbersome. It's going to first going to be very expensive and it is going to further delay your deliverables. So look at another context. For whatever reason, customer wants to stop the project halfway through, say somewhere in the month of June, July. For whatever reason, what do the customer get? Do they get half the solution? No. The customer probably may get a nice requirements analysis document and a nice design document. And if the customer is lucky, he may get some code, some working code, and most of the code, which are just code, may not be working. So that is what the customer gets. And what do they do with that? Having invested close to 50% of the cost of this particular software development, what do they get is nothing. And they cannot make use of that in their business. Very difficult.